Welcome to the 1 minute apologist. 1 minute apologist. If you had 1 minute apologia to be able to unpack for the audience,
we interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
Welcome to the 1 minute apologist. My name is Bobby Conway. I am here with Alan DiDonato. Alan, it's a privilege to be with you, buddy.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, my pleasure. One of your passions is really dealing with some myth ideas, and as a teacher of this substance and this content, we know in our culture today, some will say Christianity isn't true because of these parallel mythic beliefs that are out there. For instance, in some of the other flood stories or like Mithra, how would you respond to those who would debunk Christianity in light of the fact there are other parallel beliefs out there?
There's a number of different ways that you could actually handle those objections. One is that the stories that we're going to look at, I mean, if they're actually parallel stories, if you actually investigate them really closely, parallels aren't as strong as sometimes the skeptic makes them out to be. Mm-hmm. So that's one way that a lot of Christians will tackle those particular issues. The other way to come at it is looking at the fact that there are parallels that exist, but they're not just in the world of the Bible. They exist beyond the borders of the Near Eastern world. And there has to be other ways to explain parallels other than borrowing. Mm-hmm. The big fault, and I think the logic of the opponents of Christianity, is that they assume that parallelism proves borrowing. They sort of construct sort of a syllogism or an argument that if there are parallels, then there's borrowing. That the parallels themselves are sufficient to guarantee that there's borrowing. And they basically reverse the order of those things. If there's borrowing, well, that guarantees that there's going to be parallels, but it's not the other way around. So they have basically a logical problem they start with. They're assuming something that is false. So even though their argument looks valid, it's not a sound argument by any means. They're starting from a false premise.
Thank you, Alan.